Okay, fine. So, very good morning to all of you. Good morning, everyone.
Yes.
Good morning. Yes, good morning to all of you. Good morning, Vidula, Samadnya, Ashlesha. Good morning. Good morning to all of you. Can you hear me? Are the voice and screen clear? All okay? Yes. Yes. Okay, fine. So, first of all, the first notice is about the Sunday test, okay? That you already know, okay? The syllabus also already declared, okay? Some part of the previous chapter and potential part of this current chapter, okay? Potential part of this current chapter that we have already covered. You have also solved the model examples, okay? Or additional examples, if you want to solve, you can do that on the Saturday, okay? As a preparation, okay? You can just see the all question and answers, okay? On Saturday, and on Sunday you can attempt the test. And in the weekdays, what we have to do? Yeah, week madhe aapla kay karayche. Now in this week we have to solve the MCQs of capacitance. Okay, now this is Thursday, right? Thursday, Friday. 2 days we will be solving the MCQs of the capacitance from the module. Okay, that we will be doing. And now remember that here onwards, as a first task. Okay, we are giving right now you three tasks. As a first task, right now we were doing the module only. But as a first task, we will be doing module plus boards, okay? Module plus boards, okay? Second task, you know it's a revision task. Third task, you know it's an optional task. Fine. So is this notice clear to all of you? This notice about the JEE NEET test. There is one more notice here. On Monday there will be physics board test, okay? You have just submitted the boards homework as well, okay? If you have not submitted, it's mandatory that you have to submit the boards homework, okay? Do that homework. That will ultimately help you in the boards test. Okay. Only the electrostatic part. Okay. Not the capacitance part. Okay. Only the electrostatic part or the potential part and electric field part. That will be for the exam. Okay. And not the potential part. Okay. All right. So just reply me once again, everyone. Are these notices clear to all of you? Everyone, no need to study separately. Just submit your homeworks and just read them again and again and again and again. That's it. That's called as preparation of exam. Now you will not be taking any kind of tension for the exam. You just keep on submitting the homeworks and just keep on reading them again and again. That will automatically prepare you for the exam, and that's the proper way to study for the exam. Okay, don't study one day before the exam. One day before the exam, yes, you can revise it, but study shall be over well before the exam. Okay, so chalo, what was the last point? Can you tell me? Okay, one more notice. We have one more chemistry teacher, right? We have one more chemistry teacher. We want to introduce him to you. Okay. So today at 4 p.m. Okay. Today at 4 p.m. there will be additional introduction lecture. Okay. Introduction lecture of chemistry teacher, right? Is this notice clear to all of you? Is this notice clear to all of you? Everyone, please reply me. We have one more chemistry teacher. We want him to introduce you. Okay, so that introduction lecture will be, guys, today at 4 p.m. Okay. All right. Chalo. So we were solving what? Yes, we derived the formula for capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, right? और कैपेसिटी ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, कैपेसिटी ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर. देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कैपेसिटर, पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, देन स्फेरिकल कैपेसिटर, देन सिलिंड्रिकल कैपेसिटर. सो कैपेसिटी ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, कैपेसिटी ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, कैपेसिटर इज अ डिवाइस, कैपेसिटी इज अ प्रॉपर्टी. व्हाट वाज द फॉर्मूला सर? द फॉर्मूला वाज ए कैपिटल के इप्सिलॉन जीरो अपॉन डी. व्हाट इज के? के इज अ डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट बिटवीन द, के इज अ डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट ऑफ मटेरियल बिटवीन द प्लेट्स. के इज अ डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट, के इज अ डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट ऑफ द मटेरियल व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इन बिटवीन द प्लेट्स. If nothing is present, you can take it as vacuum or air. If nothing is present between the plates, if no data of medium is given, if no data of medium is given, in that situation, you will take that as a air and you will simply use the formula A epsilon 0 upon D. Because for the air or for the vacuum, this dielectric constant, some people call it as epsilon R also, no issues. That value for the air or vacuum is equal to 1. Okay, that value for air or vacuum is equal to 1. Okay, fine. Now let me check what is the next point. All right. Okay. Just give me 1 second. I want to modify this sequence. Okay. All right. Write down. Write down formula for, it's not given in the module, but I will write it. Write down capacity of spherical capacitor, capacity of spherical capacitor. Let us draw the spherical capacitor. I am not saying spherical conductor. Okay, I am not saying spherical conductor. I am saying spherical capacitor. It's a system. Capacitor is a system of two conductors. Okay, fine sir. Of course, inner sphere will be having some charge, let's say Q. So automatically outer sphere will have induced charges on it. Automatically outer sphere will have induced charges on it like this. And the positive induced charges will be on the outer surface of the outer sphere. Outer surface of the outer sphere, but those will be grounded. Those will be grounded. Fine. Now let's say the radius of the inner sphere is small a. And let's see the radius of the outer sphere is small b. Okay, inner sphere radius small a, outer sphere radius small b. And the formula for spherical plate capacitor is, capacity of spherical plate capacitor is 4 pi epsilon 0 divided by 1 upon a minus 1 upon b. This is the formula. 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. Now we will not be deriving this formula. Okay. This derivation is definitely not for the boards. So we will not put our time in that. Okay. Of course the logic is this. Of course the logic is derivation of this formula goes with this logic. C is equal to Q upon V, where V is the potential difference between these two plates and Q is the charge stored. And Q is the charge stored on one of the plates. Okay, Q is the charge stored on one of the plates. This is the basic logic. With this, we can derive this, certainly derive this, but we will not waste time in that. Okay, you also do not waste time in that. Okay, capacity of parallel plate capacitor, this we have derived because that can appear in the board exam. So we have derived that, but this we will not derive. This I remember. So you also have to remember. Okay, thodasa kaam balano smartly karava lagto. That we will do. So this formula you have to remember, 4 pi epsilon 0 divided by 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. But if you have spherical conductor, if you have spherical conductor, try to understand. If you have spherical conductor, Let me show the spherical conductor here. In that situation, what happens? If you have the spherical conductor of radius equal to small r or capital R, whatever you want to say, in that situation, capacity of the spherical conductor, this formula also we have derived. It is 4 pi epsilon 0 capital R. It is simply 4 pi epsilon 0 capital R. But here, you can also check the unit. 4 pi epsilon 0, and now the unit should be of length r, and 1 upon length minus 1 upon length. So ultimately here you will have the unit of length. Okay, so these two formulae you can confirm with the units. Okay, or you can cross check for the units. 4 pi epsilon 0 r mje length unit yayla paije. 4 pi epsilon 0, after that there should be unit of length. So 1 upon a minus 1 upon b means 1 upon length. 1 upon length, length goes into numerator. So unit of length. Okay, that in this way you can verify or remember this. Okay, and of course remember that capacity is going to be a positive number. So 1 upon small radius minus 1 upon big radius. 1 upon small is equal to big. Big minus small. 1 upon small value is a large value minus 1 upon large value is a small value. So 1 upon small means large. So large minus small. So you should get a positive number. You should get a positive number because capacity is always a positive quantity. Okay, so 1 upon inner radius minus 1 upon outer radius. Okay, always remember this. Also write down one more formula. Just club down the formula. Capacity of cylindrical capacitor. Capacity of cylindrical capacitor. Capacity of cylindrical capacitor. Now let us try to draw the cylindrical capacitor. Let us try to draw the cylindrical capacitor. Inner shell, inner cylinder, outer cylinder, right? Inner cylinder, outer cylinder, and just draw the lines like this. You draw it properly. Just give me 1 second. You draw it properly. Draw a cylindrical capacitor. Sir, I didn't understand capacity of spherical conductor. Spherical conductor? That formula we have already derived. Capacity of spherical conductor, formula we have already derived. Absent was ka lecture la. What is the capacity of spherical conductor? 4 pi epsilon 0 r. Capacity of parallel plate capacitor, a k epsilon 0 upon d. How we derived this? We derive this like this. C is equal to Q upon V. C is equal to Q upon V. So Q is the charge on the spherical conductor. What is the potential at a point on the surface of the conductor? Potential is KQ upon R. K is K. Q is Q upon R on the surface. So R will be equal to capital R. R will be equal to capital R. Sir, this Q cancel. This R goes in the numerator. This K in the denominator as it is, K as it is, now R as it is, K is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, this 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, this 4 pi epsilon 0 goes in the numerator into the capital R as it is. So that's the formula for capacity of a spherical capacitor. This we have already done, okay. This we have already done. Now here we are having some cylindrical capacitor. You draw it properly, you draw the straight lines properly, because here I have to join the ends exactly, so that might take some time, but you just draw it properly. Fine. So inner sphere having inner shell having charge equal to Q, outer shell having charge equal to minus q, and the outer surface of outer shell having charge equal to plus q, but that will be grounded. That will be grounded. Now let's say the inner radius is small a. Inner radius is small a. Let us write it here. And let's say the outer radius is small b. Try to draw it properly. Okay, inner radius is small a, outer radius small b, or here I can show it properly. Inner radius is small a and outer radius is small b. Outer radius is small b. And what is the formula here? The formula here is, of course, I have to draw one more dimension. The length, this length of the inner and the outer shell is equal to, let's say, small l, is equal to, let's say, small l. Now the formula that you have to write is 2 pi epsilon 0 l capacity of cylindrical capacitor. Of course, again the logic is same. Charge on the plate, charge on the inner plate or the inner shell or the outer shell, any shell that you want, one of the charge divided by potential difference between these two conductors. Okay, in this way you have to find out the capacity, but now we will not be deriving that because that is definitely not required. So the formula is 2 pi epsilon 0. Okay, 4 pi epsilon 0, just like that, 2 pi epsilon 0. Now there should be unit of length. Ata itha length unit ala paije, just write down here length, divided by the term containing a and b. The term containing a and b is ln. Ln means log to the base e. ln b upon a. Log of value which is more than 1. More than 1 means larger value upon smaller value. B is the outer radius, so it is larger value upon smaller value. Larger value upon smaller value. What I remember is here in the denominator there is a log of value which is more than 1. Log of value which is more than 1 is a positive value, and capacity is always a positive value. So log of value more than 1 should be there. So B upon A, higher value upon lower value, more radius upon less radius, or larger radius upon smaller radius. Reply me up to this point. Is that clear to all of you and written? This formula we simply have to remember. Balanno he fakta lakshat thevayche. This I remember, you also have to remember, rather than deriving it. Good. Yes. Direct formula based question also. Direct on this and this. On this and this, direct formula based question. So nothing to worry about. Okay. Even in the module, they have avoided the derivations because they know these derivations are definitely not required. And of course, fundamentally, derivation starts from this formula. C is equal to Q upon V. Okay, every time it starts from this formula itself. Next. Now we can move on to the next point. The next point is dielectrics and polarization. Write down the heading. Dielectrics and polarization. Okay. So this is very interesting point. Dielectrics and polarization. Okay. Now write down, what are the dielectrics? Dielectrics are non-conducting materials. Or simply non-conductors. That's it. Dielectrics are non-conductors. Okay, sir. There are two types of dielectrics. Number one, polar dielectrics. Number two, non-polar dielectrics. Just keep on writing. This is theoretical point. First is polar. The dielectrics. Whose molecules have, just keep on writing, permanent परमानेंट डायपोल मूमेंट, परमानेंट डायपोल मूमेंट आर कॉल्ड एज पोलर डाइइलेक्ट्रिक्स, आर कॉल्ड एज पोलर डाइइलेक्ट्रिक्स, आर कॉल्ड एज पोलर डाइइलेक्ट्रिक्स. एग्जाम्पल एग्जाम्पल वॉटर वॉटर. ओके, इफ यू हैव वॉटर एंड इफ यू चेक द मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ वॉटर, हियर देर इज ऑक्सीजन, हियर देर इज अ हाइड्रोजन, हियर देर इज अ हाइड्रोजन. ऑक्सीजन इज स्लाइटली मोर इलेक्ट्रोनिगेटिव, सो डेल्टा माइनस. हाइड्रोजन इज इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव कंपेयर्ड विद द ऑक्सीजन, सो डेल्टा प्लस. Oxygen again more electronegative than the hydrogen, delta minus. Hydrogen less electronegative, so delta plus. Dipole moment is always from negative to positive. Dipole moment is always from negative to positive. So this is your resultant dipole moment. This is the resultant dipole moment. P. So water molecule has permanent dipole moment. Water molecule has permanent dipole moment. So water as a material, it is called as polar dielectric. Water as a material, it is called as polar dielectric because its molecule has permanent dipole moment. Its molecule has permanent dipole moment. Next example is, can you give me one example? Right up to this and give me one example of polar dielectric. Let me give you one more, HCl. HCl is also the polar dielectric. Compared with the chlorine, hydrogen is electropositive and chlorine is electronegative. Dipole moment is always from negative to positive. So it has a non-zero SO2. What is the structure of SO2? Is it linear molecule? SO2. SO2 is a linear or non-linear? If it is linear, certainly it will be non-polar. If it is non-linear, it will be polar. Sir, what does permanent dipole mean? Permanent dipole mean dipole. Dipole manje kay? Plus q and minus q. If there is a separation of charges plus q and minus q, there exists a physical quantity called as dipole moment. Jaja molecule la dipole moment ahe, tya molecules na kay manaycha? Polar molecules. Now what is the meaning of permanent? Permanent cha meaning asa hai ki to kadhi zero honar nahi hai. Meaning of permanent is it is not going to become zero. Yes, no. Water molecule has permanent dipole moment. It's not going to get zero anytime. It's not going to get zero. So, kadhi zero honar nahi hai. So, it is called as permanent. If it is getting zero sometimes, so it will be called as temporary. Okay, fine. So, HCl. One more example I got, that was SO2, but I don't know what is the structure of SO2. Definitely it is going to be a triangular structure because only three points are there. SO2, the structure has to be this. The structure has to be this. If it is non-linear molecule, SO2 structure must be something like this. Okay, now we are not drawing the number of bonds, single bond, double bond, that we are not going to draw. Okay, but here who is more electronegative, oxygen or sulfur? That you have to tell me now. Oxygen or sulfur, who is more electronegative? Who is more electronegative? Oxygen. Okay, fine. So oxygen is more electronegative, so delta minus. So delta minus, delta plus, very good, delta plus. So negative to positive, it will be like this dipole moment. This dipole moment will be like this, and the resultant of this dipole moment, equivalent dipole moment, will be, let me draw first vector here, this vector and this vector here. Okay, and ultimately as a result of these two vectors, the resultant vector I will get like this. So SO2 will be having some permanent dipole moment like this. Okay, similarly NH3 and other molecules, of course you can give the examples like that. Okay, now there is a second type of molecules which are called as, or second type of substances which are called as polar dielectric, non-polar dielectrics. So write down about them. Non-polar dielectrics. non-polar dielectrics. The dielectrics whose molecules have, just keep on writing, whose molecules do not have dipole moment, are called non-polar dielectrics, are called as non-polar dielectrics. Example, let me give you the example of non-polar dielectric. As I want some liquid or solid material as an example. Let me check what example that they have given. Of course, we can have gases, no issues, O2, H2, all those examples. Of course, those examples we can have. No, that example they have not given. You try to give the examples of substances which have non-polar molecules. Non-polar molecule by you. CO2 is a non-polar molecule. Yes, CO2 is a non-polar molecule. O2, CO2, molecule should be non-polar. There should not be dipole moment. What is O3, ozone? It's a linear molecule, O3, is it linear molecule? No. But all the three oxygens are of same electronegativity, right? So you think on this, everyone. After this lecture, you will check whether O3 is polar or non-polar. Okay, additional information. Okay, think over O3. Okay, or you can just search on that. Of course, N2, perfect. I think O3 will be polar. Okay, electronegativity of all the three oxygens. Check whether it is exactly same in that structure or not. You just think on this, okay, after the lecture. We don't want to make this complex, okay? We just want to keep it simple. It's just a theoretical point in physics, so we are just considering it. Okay, all right, fine. Even if you liquefy CO2, the CO2 molecule will remain as a CO2, right? So even in that case, it is a non-polar dielectric. What is the structure of CO2? It's like this. Oxygen is more electronegative, so negative to positive dipole moment like this. Delta minus delta plus. But the net dipole moment is zero. So molecule is non-polar. As a molecule, it has zero dipole moment. This bond is polar bond because there is a dipole moment. Okay. So this molecule, as a result, these two dipoles cancel each other. So it's a non-polar dielectric. Okay. So now we understand about what is the polar dielectric. Okay. When the material is called as polar, and when the material is called as non-polar dielectric. What is the meaning of dielectric? Sir, the meaning of dielectric is non-conductor. It's a non-conductor. Non-conductors, in the proper words, it is called as dielectrics. Okay. Next. The next thing that I want to write is behavior of dielectrics. Just keep on writing. Behavior of dielectrics in presence of external electric field. Try to understand behavior of dielectrics in presence of external electric field. Okay, let us try to understand this. First of all, let us take polar dielectrics. polar dielectrics. Okay sir, polar dielectrics. Okay, let us apply external electric field equal to zero. Let us apply external electric field equal to zero. Let us denote the external electric field by the symbol capital E. External electric field by the symbol capital E. Okay, that is equal to zero. Fine, sir. Now let us draw the dielectric material. Okay, right now we have not applied any external electric field to the dielectric. Okay, sir. We have not applied any external electric field to this. Okay, but it is a polar dielectric. So how to draw the polar dielectric material? By ellipse. It is to be drawn like ellipse, positive, negative. But these ellipse means dipole moments are randomly oriented. Okay, one negative to positive, negative to positive, any random direction it is oriented. Okay, so any random direction you can draw, but it is to be indicated with the help of ellipse so that people can understand that it is a non-polar dielectric. So that people can understand it is a non-polar dielectric. So these are the molecules. Okay, every single dipole is a molecule. Every molecule is polar. Positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay, in this way you can denote the non-polar dielectric. Okay, now here dipole moment of molecule, dipole moment of molecule, when the external electric field applied is zero, dipole moment of molecule. Yes, every molecule has dipole moment. Every molecule has dipole moment. Dipole moment ahe, ahe. Yes, present. Present means not equal to zero. Ahe na, ahe manje non-zero. Every molecule has some dipole moment. But substance, dipole moment of substance, it is called as net dipole moment. Dipole moment of substance is called as net dipole moment. All these dipoles are randomly oriented, so ultimately they get cancelled. Any random orientation in nature ultimately cancels each other. Okay, and ultimately it results into zero. So therefore substance has zero dipole moment. Reply me in the chat box, is this clear to all of you? Molecule la dipole moment ahe, pan substance la dipole moment nahi. Is this clear to all of you? Molecule has dipole moment but substance has zero dipole moment. CW. External electric field is zero. External electric field is zero. CW. Sir, not even little bit. Okay. Why not? Anshu is saying, sir, why substance will not have any dipole moment? For given instance of time, for given instance of time, let's say this substance has a dipole moment. On the next instance of time, because of these random orientations and there is a change in this orientation as well. Okay, this orientation is also not permanent. Okay, so for given instance of time, even if the substance has dipole moment, on the next instance it is going to be vanished, it is going to change its orientation. Okay, so as a result, over the interval of time, over the finite interval of time, this material has zero dipole moment. So that's the logic. All these random orientations will add up to get zero. Okay, always remember this. Now let's say we apply the external electric field. Now let's say we apply the external electric field to this to this polar dielectric. What happens is very simple phenomena. Now we are applying the external electric field in this direction. We are applying the external electric field. So what happens? This material is placed in the external electric field. This material is placed in the external electric field. Now you know that all the dipoles always try to align in the direction of electric field. All the dipoles always try to align in the direction of external electric field. Means what? Because of the electric field, positive charge will be repelled and negative charge will be attracted. So positive will be repelled, negative will be attracted. So it will try to align like this. This positive charge will experience force in the direction of field. Negative charge will experience force in the opposite direction of field. So this dipole will rotate and will try to align in the direction of field. So every positive charge will experience force in the direction of field. Negative charge will experience force in the opposite direction of field. All the dipoles will try to align in the direction of field. All the dipoles will try to align in the direction of field. All the dipoles will try to align in the direction of field. The number of dipoles getting aligned, the number of dipoles getting aligned depends, actually depends on the strength of the electric field. Number of dipoles getting aligned, most of the dipoles try to align themselves in the direction of electric field, but every dipole will not get aligned. Every dipole will not get aligned. And how many dipoles will get aligned, that actually depends on strength of the electric field. Okay, strength of the electric field. So let us try to write these facts. Here, each and every molecule has some dipole moment. Dipole moment ahe. Ahe means not equal to zero. Dipole moment is present. Present means not equal to zero. Now, dipole moment of substance, it is called as net dipole moment. Now you people tell me, net dipole moment will be equal to zero or not equal to zero? Most of the dipoles have been aligned in the direction of field. Zero or non-zero? Z or N? Huh, some dipoles are still randomly oriented, but most of the dipoles are trying to align. Zero or non-zero? Prithviraj, why it will be zero? Most of the dipoles are in the rightward direction. Most of the vectors rightward, randomly oriented nahi hai. Everyone, zero or non-zero? As most of the vectors are pointing in the rightward direction, there will be some net rightward dipole moment. There will be some net rightward dipole moment. There will be some net rightward dipole moment. This dipole moment will not be zero. This dipole moment will not be equal to zero. Okay. And I can now say that the net dipole moment of the substance is actually proportional to number of dipoles getting aligned. Number of dipoles getting aligned. Number of dipoles getting aligned with electric field. Just try to write and try to understand. Number of net dipole moment of the substance is proportional to number of dipoles getting aligned with electric field. With electric field, but number of dipoles getting aligned with electric field, that is proportional to what? That is proportional to strength of electric field, means magnitude of electric field. That is proportional to strength of electric field or magnitude of electric field. Up to this, reply me in the chat box. Agree, disagree, and clear and written. Itaparyanta samajla ka check kara. Good. Fine. So, sir, can we now write A proportional to B, B proportional to C? Mag balano asa monya. Net dipole moment of substance is proportional to external electric field. Yes. Net dipole moment of substance is proportional to external electric field. So, let me show it on the next page. So net dipole moment of substance, P net means dipole moment of substance, is proportional to external electric field. Okay, call this as equation 1. Now there is one more physical quantity which is now to be defined. Let us define that physical quantity. Polarization. The net dipole moment of substance, the net dipole moment of substance, net dipole moment of substance per unit volume, is called polarization, is called as polarization. Now the symbol for the polarization is again P. Polarization का symbol for P है. For dipole moment you can use small p letter. For the polarization you have to use capital P letter. But while writing it is not practically possible to draw small p and capital P differently. So what I do personally is this. I draw it like this. So हा जो काय P है याची रेष फार मोठी करतोय. I draw it like this. So I can now understand that this is a polarization. That's a त्याची जी काय रेष आहे. Okay. The line for this P for polarization. I draw it very long so that I can easily understand that we are talking about polarization. So polarization is defined as dipole moment of substance divided by volume of the substance. Dipole moment of substance divided by volume of substance. So it's very simple. P net upon volume. It's P net upon volume. Polarization is P net upon volume. P net means dipole moment, total dipole moment of the substance divided by volume of the substance. This is called as polarization. This is called as polarization. This is the definition of polarization. Now you will say, sir, this polarization is directly proportional to net dipole moment because volume is going to be the constant value. Volume tar constant asna. So polarization is proportional to P net and net dipole moment is proportional to external electric field. So again A proportional to B, B proportional to C. So sir, can we write P proportional to, that is polarization, capital P. Okay, draw it like this. Capital P proportional to E. Yes sir, you can write. Therefore sir, what is the proportionality constant here? Capital P is equal to, this symbol is called as chi, this symbol is called as chi into capital E. So I have written chi and small e. So write down where chi small e is equal to electric susceptibility, a new physical quantity. It's a constant for given material. It is the property of material, electric susceptibility. Susceptibility. Don't bother about the spelling, okay? No extra marks will be given for the correct spelling and no marks will be deducted for wrong spelling. So just don't worry. So it's called as electric susceptibility. So this formula we have to remember. This formula, it gets automatically remembered. P equal to chi into E. Just like A, B, C, D are the names of the letters. What is the name of this letter? What is the name of this letter? Chi. Okay. Don't call it as X. It's Chi. It's not X. It's Chi. Okay. Reply me in the chat box. Up to this clear and written. Up to this clear and written. CW. Polarization we have defined now. Polarization. Last slide. You want last slide? Okay. If you apply external electric field to the dielectric, the dipoles try to get aligned. More the dipoles getting aligned, more will be the dipole moment of the substance. So dipole moment of the substance is proportional to number of dipoles getting aligned. But number of how many dipoles will align, that actually depends on the strength of the electric field. More the electric field, more will be the number of dipoles getting aligned. Okay, so dipole moment is proportional to number of dipoles getting aligned, but number of dipoles getting aligned is proportional to electric field. So these two will be proportional to each other. A proportional to B, B proportional to C. And similarly here, polarization is proportional to net dipole moment, but net dipole moment is proportional to external electric field. So people call polarization A proportional to B, B proportional to C. From that logic, people call this polarization proportional to external electric field. And here the proportionality constant is a new physical quantity called as susceptibility of the material. It's the property of material. For a given material, it is fixed. It's property of material. It indicates how easily dipoles of the materials get aligned. How easily dipoles of the material get aligned with the external electric field. Indication of that is given by this physical quantity called as electric susceptibility. Dipoles kiti easily align hotat. Te balanno sangayacha kaam kon karta? Electric susceptibility karte. Okay. Fine, sir. All right. Now let's have more fun with these dielectrics. Now let us apply very high electric field. Okay. Ata gammat baga. Let us try to apply very high value of electric field to these dielectrics. Let us apply very high value of electric field. Let us try to apply very high value of electric field. What will happen? If you apply very high value of electric field to these materials, all the dipoles present in the substance will get aligned. All the dipoles present in the substance will get aligned. That's it. That's what will ultimately happen. Every dipole, every single molecule and its dipole moment will get aligned in the direction of field. Negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. Every single molecule will get aligned in the direction of external electric field. Negative will experience force in the opposite direction of field, positive in the direction of field. So ultimately, in presence of external field, dipole always gets aligned in the direction of external electric field. Okay. So if the value of electric field is very high, if E becomes very high, E becomes very high, all the dipoles will get aligned in the direction of external field. That's what will happen. That's it. Write it down and then reply me in the chat box, clear and written. If you apply very high electric field, good. Yes. Okay. All right. Now. सर फील्ड इमिशन झालं तर व्हाट आर यू सेइंग काय बोलतोस तू फील्ड इमिशन झालं तर म्हणजे त्यासाठी तिथे गॅस पाहिजे हा सॉलिड आहे दिस इज सॉलिड इट्स नॉट दॅट इझी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स बाहेर पडले मटेरियल मध्ये पडतील परत कॅप्चर होतील परत कॅप्चर पण होतील ऑफकोर्स वेरियस फेनोमेना आर सायमल्टेनियसली पॉसिबल बट वी आर फोकसिंग ओनली ऑन वन फेनोमेना ट्राय टू आस्क पर्टिक्युलर क्वेश्चन जनरलाइज क्वेश्चन विचारू नका हे झालं तर ते झालं तर तसं नाही हळूहळू समजेल काय विचारायचंय काय नाही यू कीप ऑन आस्किंग आय विल टेल यू व्हॉट कॅन बी आस्क अँड व्हॉट कॅनॉट बी मेनी थिंग्स कॅन हॅपन हिअर ओके मेनी थिंग्स कॅन हॅपन हिअर फाईन ऑल राईट Of course, if you keep on increasing and increasing the electric field, yes, there is a possibility of field emission. Okay, the atoms might get ionized. Okay, because of the electrons escaping from the surface of this material. Okay, ya material cha surface madhe the electrons emit hotil. That is also the possibility. Yes, it is quite possible. But this is not metal, so it's definitely not that possible. Okay, in metals you have free electrons. and free electrons can be easily removed. But this is a dielectric material. It does not have any kind of free electrons. All the electrons are bound to the atom. Okay. And that atom is really very strong enough. The nucleus is really very strong enough to hold those electrons. So these, even if the values of electric fields are very high, it's not possible for them to escape. Okay. So that's not a very easy and obvious phenomena. That's not an obvious phenomena. If you keep on increasing at some point of time, okay, that might be the possibility. Okay, fine, sir. Next. So can I draw the graph like this? You try to understand. Check if I am right or wrong. I want to draw the polarization or the net dipole moment. Let me draw the net dipole moment. Or you can draw the polarization also. No issues. You can draw the polarization also, because both of these are directly proportional to each other. And this is the external electric field. As you go on increasing the external electric field, net dipole moment of the substance goes on increasing. But what happens after some times, all the dipoles will get aligned. Once all the dipoles get aligned, maximum dipole moment of the substance is achieved. Now that dipole moment will not increase. So you keep on increasing the field, but at some times all the dipoles get aligned. Once all the dipoles get aligned, maximum dipole moment or the maximum polarization has been achieved. Now polarization will not increase, and you are keeping increasing the external electric field. So this should be the graph. Reply me in the chat box yes or no. Dipole moment is proportional to external field. Proportionality straight line. For some time it will be a straight line. Now once all the dipoles get aligned, dipole moment will not increase anymore. It will remain constant. These are some higher points, that is the graph points. We can understand them because you know the proportionality. Okay. So in this way, polar dielectrics will behave in the presence of external electric field. Okay. This was behavior of polar dielectrics in the presence of external electric field. This was the behavior of polar dielectric in presence of external electric field. Now, what will be the behavior of non-polar dielectrics in the presence of external electric field? Let us try to draw it. So write down. Non-polar dielectrics. So let us apply external electric field equal to zero. But the material is non-polar. Material non-polar means its molecules are non-polar. Non-polar molecule is to be denoted by circle and not ellipse. It is to be denoted by circle because positive and negative charge are not separate. They coincide. No dipole moment means circle and dipole moment means ellipse. So here you have to show the circles. Okay. Fine, sir. So here we have applied external electric field zero. What is the dipole moment of molecule? Sir, molecule is non-polar. So molecule is non-polar means dipole moment of the molecule. Molecule la dipole moment nahi. Nahi manje kiti hai? Zero hai. Nahi means zero. No means zero. Molecule has no dipole moment. Molecule has dipole moment nahi hai. Substance la kaisa hai? So dipole moment of the substance is called as net dipole moment, P net. That is also equal to zero. Okay. Is this point clear to all of you? Reply in the chat box. Molecule, no dipole moment. Substance, no dipole moment. Molecule has no substance. And external field is zero. No field is applied. Now let us apply the external electric field. Now let us apply the external electric field to these materials. Let us apply the external electric field to the non-polar material. What will happen? The positive charge will experience force in the direction of electric field. Negative will experience in the opposite direction of field. The molecule which was initially non-polar, their charge separation will take place. Charge separation will take place. Molecule will automatically become polar. Molecule will automatically become polar. So molecule will get polarized. Initially it was non-polar, but now the molecule will get polarized. Every molecule will not get polarized. Every molecule will not get polarized, but most of the molecules will try to get polarized. Reply me in the chat box, yes or no. Bayer Nofil Lawley. If you apply external electric field, molecules will get polarized. Every molecule will not get, but most of the molecules will try to get polarized. Simple, simple thought, one line thought. Very good. Sir, for example, we take CO2, then its structure has to get changed to get polar. Yes. Don't say for the structure, it's a linear molecule. But charge separation will definitely take place. Structure might remain linear, but definitely the charge separation will take place. Or if required, structure will be modified from linear to triangular. If required, structure will get modified from linear to triangular. But non-polar molecule will get polarized. Non-polar molecule will get polarized. This is what will happen. Okay. Fine, sir. Ata tumcha doka chala lagle. Yes. So write down here. External electric field is present. Present means not zero. Bayer no field Lawley, right? Dipole moment of molecule, zero or non-zero. Molecules now have the dipole moment. Huh? Every molecule is not polarized, but now most of the molecules have the dipole moment. Have means present. Dipole moment present. Present means not equal to zero. Dipole moment of substance, most of the dipole moment, see the new dipole that is formed, that has formed, jo navin dipole tayar zala hai, that is already aligned, that is already aligned. So there is no random orientation as such, there is no random orientation as such. Most of the dipole moments, see, the dipole moment initially was not present, now it is present, and it is present in the aligned state itself. So aligned state madhech tayar hoto. So this is random orientation cha prashnas nasto. There is no case of random orientation. So as there is no random orientation and these vectors are aligned in the direction of electric field, there will be net dipole moment to the substance. Substance will have some net dipole moment. Ahe means present. Present means not equal to zero. Okay, so substance will have some net dipole moment. Let me write it properly. Dipole moment of substance is called as net dipole moment, and this net dipole moment is not equal to zero. This net dipole moment is not equal to zero. Okay, fine. Now if you try to apply very high electric field, what will happen? Let me draw it on the next page. All the molecules will get polarized, right? So let me write here itself. If you apply very high electric field, all the molecules will get polarized. Initially most of the molecules got polarized, but some molecules remain unpolarized, they remain as they are. But if you apply very high value of electric field, all the molecules will get polarized. Yes, that's it, full stop. If you apply very high value of electric field, how many number of molecules will get polarized? That will depend on the amount of electric field or strength of the electric field. Up to this, reply in the chat box, clear and written. Itaparyanta balanno samajtay ka amhala. बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग गोष्ट आहे, गम्मत आहे याच्यात. येस व्हेरी गुड. चलो नाउ लेट अस ट्राय टू फाइंड आउट वन मोर थिंग. लेट अस ट्राय टू फाइंड आउट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इनसाइड द डायइलेक्ट्रिक. काय गम्मत आहे बघ, इनसाइड मेटल्स इनसाइड कंडक्टर्स नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज झिरो. Now let us try to find out electric field inside a dielectric. Inside a dielectric. Try to understand. Electric field inside a dielectric. See what are the thoughts. See what are the thoughts. Whenever you apply some external electric field, whenever you apply some external electric field to the dielectric, what happens? Ultimately, let it be a polar, let it be a non-polar, if you apply external electric field, this substance will ultimately get polarized. This substance will ultimately get polarized. So when you apply the external electric field, when you apply the external electric field to the substance, ultimately let the substance be the polar or non-polar dielectric, ultimately substance will get polarized. Tumcha substance polar asu de adhi pasun nahitar adhi pasun non-polar asu de, but if you apply external electric field the substance will get polarized. Ultimately negative charge will be available on this surface and positive charge will be available on this surface. या सरफेस वरती निगेटिव्ह चार्ज असेल, या सरफेस वरती पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज असेल, कारण चार्ज सेपरेशन होणार आहे. निगेटिव्ह विल बी अट्रॅक्टेड, पॉझिटिव्ह विल बी रिपेल्ड. सो हियर यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व, ओके, दिस निगेटिव्ह साईड, दिस विल बी द निगेटिव्ह साईड अँड दिस साईड विल बी द पॉझिटिव्ह साईड. दिस साईड विल बी द पॉझिटिव्ह साईड. अगेन हियर यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व, दिस साईड विल बी अल्टिमेटली द निगेटिव्ह साईड and this side will be ultimately the positive side. So let me show here this side as the negative side. In between no need to draw, madhe kay jale draw karayachi garaj. So this surface or this region will be negatively charged and this region will be equally positively charged. This region will be equally positively charged. So at a point inside the dielectric, there are two electric fields which are present. First electric field is the external electric field. First electric field is the external electric field. And now these are the induced charges. Call it as Q induced. Call this as Q induced. These are called as induced charges. And induced charge per unit area is called as sigma induced. Induced charge per unit area is called as sigma induced. Okay, charges get induced on the surface of this plate, okay, or the dielectric slab. Now this material is called as dielectric slab because its shape is rectangular slab. Okay, rectangular slab sarka hai to. Okay, it's a three dimensional object. Of course it's a three dimensional object like this. It's a three dimensional object. Try to understand. And this three dimensional object we are observing from the front. We are observing like this. We are observing from this like this. So this region is the negatively charged region and this region, entire region, is a positively charged region. Try to understand. Okay, that we are writing here, that we are writing here. Okay sir, fine. So in the presence of external electric field at a point inside the slab, there will be presence of two electric fields. First electric field is the external electric field and the second electric field will be because of this induced charges, because of this positive charge away from the positive, because of this negative charge away from the towards the negative, positive pasun away and negative la towards. So there will be field because of this positive charge which is away from the positive charge. There will be field because of this negative charge which will be towards the negative charge. So addition of electric fields of these two charges is called as E internal or E induced. This is called as induced electric field. and because of the presence of these two electric fields inside the dielectric field, there is a decrease in the value of total electric field. Therefore, net electric field inside the dielectric field, inside the dielectric, total electric field aaya na, net rightward field is equal to all rightward minus all leftward, all rightward minus all leftward. So because of this induced electric field, because of these induced charges, there is one induced electric field. Kahi charges surface par induce hota, and because of those charges, one extra electric field is produced. That extra electric field is opposing the external electric field, and therefore net electric field is less than the external electric field. Is this thought clear to all of you? Is this thought clear to all of you? Bola bola. Everyone. Small c. That electric field inside dielectric is less than the external. External peksha ti less asel. Because it is getting opposed. The external field la oppose hote thoda sa. बघा बाळांनो समजते का? आर यू गेटिंग दिस? दीज आर न्यू थिंग्स आय नो, सो वी आर टेकिंग टाइम, बट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टँड दीज थिंग्स ऑल्सो. पण हळूहळू या सगळ्या गोष्टी बाळांनो समजल्या सुद्धा पाहिजे. तो व्हेरी गुड एव्हरीवन. नेट फील्ड इनसाइड, net field inside the dielectric is slightly less. It is going to be less because of the presence of these induced charges. Charges surface varti kya hota hai? Induce hota hai. When you apply external electric field, this substance will get polarized. This substance will get ultimately polarized. Means what? Ya substance madhe charge separation zala. So ek charge ya surface varti gaya negative and ek charge ya surface varti gaya positive. So because of the negative, there will be the electric field towards negative. Because of the positive, there will be electric field away from the positive. So that extra electric field is called as induced electric field. That extra electric field is called as induced electric field. So that will ultimately reduce the net electric field. Net field in the rightward direction is equal to all rightward minus all leftward. All rightward minus all leftward. Okay. All right. Fine. Now let us try to produce external electric field with the help of the plates. With the help of the plates, try to understand. Ata gammat baga bana. Let's say on this plate, mhanje capacitors gyala bolu apan, nothing else. Let's say on this plate there is a plus charge, on this plate there is a minus charge. On this plate there is a minus charge. These are our plates. Okay sir, fine. Now inside these plates, let us put the dielectric material. Okay, now what will happen, sir? Or let us not put the dielectric material immediately. What is the total electric field in this region? Because of this positive charge, sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. Because of this negative charge, again sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. Positive mule kiti? Sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. Negative mule kiti? Sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. So ultimately, sigma upon 2 epsilon plus sigma upon 2 epsilon, the net answer will be sigma upon epsilon. Because of positive and because of negative, net electric field in this region is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. Okay, initially we should write sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. No material is present. So we will write sigma upon 2 epsilon 0 plus sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. That will give us sigma upon epsilon 0. That will give us sigma upon epsilon 0. This is the external electric field. Okay, now what we are going to do? Now we are putting one dielectric material here. we are putting one dielectric material here. Now what will happen? Charges will get induced. Whether it is a polar dielectric, non-polar dielectric, doesn't matter. Ultimately, the substance will get polarized. Okay, sir. And because of these additional positive and negative charges, at the same point, because of the positive, away from the positive, because of the negative, towards negative. And let's say this charge density is sigma. This charge density is sigma. This charge density is minus sigma induced. This charge density is plus sigma induced. This is your minus sigma on this plate. This is your plus sigma on this plate. And this is the induced charge. Because of the induced charge density, because of the positive charge, one total induced electric field will be what? Because of this induced positive charge, sigma upon 2 epsilon 0 means sigma induced upon 2 epsilon 0 plus, because of this induced negative charge, sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. Don't bother about directions, we have already considered. Because of this positive charge, away from the positive, because of this negative charge, away from the negative. This is the induced electric field. Up to this, reply in the chat box, clear and written. Material nastana kiti ali asti, ani material thevlyanantar induced charges je ale, because of those induced charges, what is the extra electric field? चेक करा बड़ा नो समझाया लग लेगा और वो समझे एक एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड तर असणारच ठीक अशी असेल पॉझिटिव आणि निगेटिव या बाहेरच्या पॉझिटिव आणि निगेटिव मुळे असेल आणि आतल्या चार्जेस मुळे कशी असेल एक इंड्यूस्ड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड असेल Therefore, net electric field inside काय असते? Net rightward field is equal to all rightward minus all leftward. All rightward किती आहे? Sigma upon epsilon zero minus induced charge चा effect जर consider केला की sigma induced upon epsilon zero. But sir, net field inside the material we always write. बघा जेव्हा व्हॅक्युम आहे तेव्हा काय लिहिता सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन झिरो व्हॅक्युम असेल तर काय लिहिलं असतं सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन झिरो पण मटेरियल असतं तर काय लिहिलं असतं सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन लिहिलं असतं सर मटेरियल आहे ना मटेरियलच्या आतली नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कशी लिहितात सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन लिहितात व्हॅक्युम असेल तर सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन झिरो लिहिलं असतं बट देर इज मटेरियल सो वी विल राईट दिस नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ॲज सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन बघा बाळा मी इथंपर्यंत समजलं का एक सस्पेन्स रिव्हील होणार आहे वी आर अबाउट टू रिव्हील अ सस्पेन्स अप टू दिस इज दॅट क्लिअर आय नो दिस इज लिटिल बिट हॅवी बट ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड टेल मी वी आर अबाउट टू रिव्हील द सस्पेन्स नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड मटेरियल असेल तर काय लिहिले असेल सिग्मा अपॉन एप्सिलॉन आणि व्हॅक्युम असती तर काय लिहिली असती सिग्मा अपॉन इप्सिलॉन झिरो सो आपण काय करायला लागलो एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आणि इंड्यूस्ड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड याची नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कॅल्क्युलेट करायला लागलो ऍट गिवन पॉइंट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सिग्मा अँड मायनस सिग्मा दी एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज प्रोड्यूस अँड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस प्लस सिग्मा इंड्यूस्ड अँड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मायनस सिग्मा इंड्यूस्ड ऍडिशनल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज प्रेझेंट ऍट द सेम पॉइंट So that will be called as net electric field. But net electric field can be directly written as sigma upon epsilon rather than doing this. So there are two ways to write the net electric field. First is directly write. Instead of, you could have written external electric field present inside the material. If there is vacuum, you could have written sigma upon epsilon zero. If there is no material, write sigma upon epsilon zero. If there is material, write sigma upon epsilon. This is the first way. And the second way is consider all the effects separately. म्हणजे या सिग्माचा या मायनस सिग्माचा एक इफेक्ट सेपरेटली घ्या आणि या सिग्मा इंड्यूसचा या मायनस सिग्मा इंड्यूसचा इफेक्ट सेपरेटली घ्या. म्हणजे मीडियम आहे असं कन्सिडर करू नका, सेपरेट सेपरेट इफेक्ट घ्या. सो वी आर रायटिंग हियर इप्सिलॉन झिरो अँड इप्सिलॉन झिरो. सो देर आर टू वेज टू राईट द नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन साइड द मटेरियल, जस्ट बाय डायरेक्टली रायटिंग इप्सिलॉन or by considering the effect of all the present charges, this charge, this charge, this charge and this charge. Ek tar saglyancha effect consider karun answer liya net field sathi. Are we going to find k? Yes, we are going to find k. We are going to find dielectric constant, fine, or rather the relation of dielectric constant and the induced electric field. Okay, next let me carry forward this relation on the next page. Try to understand. Sigma upon epsilon is equal to sigma upon epsilon 0 minus sigma induced upon epsilon 0. Let me write this relation once again. Net electric field direct can be written like this, or it can be written like this also. Now you can say, sir, can I write it like this? Yes, epsilon can be written as epsilon 0 k. Okay. Just keep on observing. Sir, epsilon 0, epsilon 0, epsilon 0 gets cancelled. So sigma upon k is equal to sigma minus sigma induced. So sigma induced on the left hand side and this sigma on the right hand side as it is. This minus as it is. This sigma upon k on the right hand side. No, sorry, this not this minus is already put on the left hand side. Ha sigma induced left la gela balanno. It will become positive. And this sigma upon k will come on to the right hand side, will become negative. So sigma induced is equal to sigma into bracket 1 minus 1 upon k. A very beautiful relation we have just derived. Why it is beautiful? You will realize it. We are about to solve a mystery. We are about to solve a mystery. Check whether this relation is clear to you or not. Bola, bola, bola. Tell me, tell me, tell me. Huh? Is this relation clear? How much charge will be induced on the dielectric? Dielectric varti kiti charge induced honar? This is the main surface charge density into bracket 1 minus 1 upon sigma. Charge density on the plate, charge density induced on the dielectric. What is the relation between these two? It is sigma into bracket 1 minus 1 upon k. Sigma into bracket 1 minus 1 upon k. Expecting reply from everyone. Huh, everyone reply fast. But shall I reveal the mystery? Huh? Mystery. Shall I reveal? Bola. Shall I reveal the mystery? This is a very interesting equation. Okay, this is a very very interesting equation. You people tell me. You people tell me, what is the dielectric constant for the metals or the conductors? Isn't it infinity? Yes sir, it is infinity. Okay, let us put infinity here. Instead of dielectric, if it is a conductor, so then you will write sigma induced is equal to sigma into bracket 1 minus 1 upon infinity. So that will become sigma into bracket 1, because 1 upon infinity is 0. So for conductors, sigma induced is equal to sigma. For insulators, it is less than sigma. For insulators, k will be having some finite value. K will be having some finite value. But for conductors, k is equal to infinity. For conductor, right, k is equal to infinity. So for conductors, sir, sigma induced is equal to sigma. Sigma induced is equal to sigma. Ab batao, if sigma and sigma induced both are equal, if sigma and sigma induced both are equal, sigma upon epsilon 0 minus sigma upon epsilon 0 will be equal to 0. So in this way, net electric field inside the conductor becomes 0. Got it? Got it? Reply in the chat box. All charge flows. Flows means what? all charge flow flows and question mark. All charge flows, don't say all charge flows. Required amount of charge will, if this is a conductor, exactly that much amount of charge, negative charge will appear on this face, exactly that much amount of positive charge will appear on this face, so that it can oppose the external field. कंडक्टर मध्ये तेवढेच चार्जेस इथे येतील, तेवढेच चार्जेस इथे येतील, जेणेकरून एक अपोजिंग जी फील्ड तयार व्हायला लागली, इंड्यूस फील्ड जी तयार व्हायला लागली ती एक्सटर्नल फील्डला कॅन्सल करेल. इफ यू इनक्रीज द एक्सटर्नल फील्ड, सम मोर चार्जेस विल नाउ अपीयर हियर, सम मोर चार्जेस विल नाउ अपीयर हियर अँड दे विल अगेन कॅन्सल द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड बिकॉज कंडक्टर हॅज लॉट्स ऑफ फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सम फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल नाउ अपीयर हियर अँड बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट सम पॉझिटिव्ह पोर्शन विल बी क्रिएटेड हियर अँड इन दिस वे इट विल ट्राय टू cancel out the internal electric field, total electric field. Okay, so for conductor, sigma induced and sigma both are equal. Okay, sir. Fine. For insulators, write down. For dielectrics, K value is between 1 to infinity. For air, it is equal to 1. For vacuum, it is equal to 1. Okay. So air and vacuum, if you put here 1 minus 1 equal to 0, nothing will be induced because air and vacuum is as good as nothing is present. Air kiwa vacuum manje kaich nahi hai, kaich nahi hai tar kai induce vayacha kai karan nahi. So you can put here 1 minus 1 0, nothing will be induced. So sigma induced will be equal to 0 in that case for air. But sigma induced to me 0 taku shakta, you can put here sigma induced 0. So only sigma will be present, only external field will be present, vacuum wali field will be present, material is absent. So for dielectrics, K is between 1 to infinity. So sigma induced is equal to sigma into bracket 1 upon 1 minus K. K is in between 1 to infinity. Therefore 1 upon K, 1 peksha mothi value na, K chi value ka hai, 1 peksha mothi hai. Will be between 0 to 1. K chi value more than 1 hai na, 1 upon K, 0 to 1 ase. Okay, actually 0 pan nasnar to, karan K infinity nahi hai. Ani 1 pan nasnar, karan K 1 pan nahi hai. It will be between 0 and 1. 0 not included, 1 is not included. Okay, so therefore 1 minus 1 upon K, 1 minus 1 upon K, 1 upon K kaya hai? Less than 1 hai. 1 upon K kaya hai? Less than 1. K is more than 1. K is more than 1. So this 1 upon K will be less than 1. 1 upon K will be less than 1. Or let us write it. K is more than 1. 1 upon K less than 1. Therefore 1 minus 1 upon K. 1 minus less than 1 is again a less than 1. Again a less than 1. Therefore sigma induced is equal to sigma into bracket 1 minus 1 upon K, but this 1 minus 1 upon K value is less than 1, so sigma induced, this value is less than 1, so this total multiplication will be less than sigma. This total multiplication is sigma induced, so that sigma induced will be less than sigma. Sigma motha hai, tela tumhi less than 1 na multiply karnar ani mag sigma induced milnar. So sigma induced is less than sigma. Up to this, reply me in the chat box. Everything taught in today's lecture clear to all of you? Behavior of polar and non-polar dielectric in presence of external electric field, that was today's content. Bola bola, are the things taught in today's lecture clear to all of you? Everyone, now we know why the K is equal to infinity for metals and how the electric field inside the metal becomes zero. Metal cha atli electric field valano kashi zero hote te pan aplyala samajlo. Sir, can we also say it's a proof that K can never be less than 1? Yes, you can say that. Certainly you can say that. Because sigma induced minimum value is 0. Yachi minimum value 0 yenar. Yachi minimum value 0 yala hito 1 paije. Mag k chi value pan 1 pasna start vayla paije. Yes. Okay. So guys, in this lecture we are going to stop at this point. Remaining things we are going to learn in the next lecture. Okay. Chalo, bye bye everyone. Let me end this lecture at this point. Okay. Chalo, bye.